feel like I've been hit by a train.
Pretty close. Well, you were either drunk or high. You were hooking up with Brooklyn.
Okay, great. Just send me the samples as soon as you get them. Thanks. Hey, the sportswear shoot is tomorrow at 3, and shoes and accessories are coming in this morning.
You're only this efficient when you're upset about something. Did you have a fight with Dante?
Worse.
Well, I'm here to sympathize. Spill.
Dante was drugged last night.
Don't leave me hanging. Tell me what happened.
I walked in on him and Brooke half naked, all over each other.
We would never. Me and Brooke.
That's what Lulu said.
What? Lulu was here too, so she thinks I mess around with Brooke too?
Yeah, she came to the door. She saw you and Brooke half naked all over each other.
What did she do? When did you see her?
I came back just before my curfew was over, and you were passed out in the bed. She was sitting with you. You were completely out of it, and she said that you didn't know where you were, and you didn't know who she was.
Wait, I didn't know who Lulu was?
Yeah, you're going on and on like you're still in Bensoners. You're acting like you never met Lulu before.
How hammered was I? I mean, did someone put something in my drink?
How much did you drink a lot last night, or?
I don't know. I had a few beers, I think.
Okay, what's the last thing you remember?
Me and Brooklyn. At Jake's.
Dante and Brooklyn. Wow, you must have freaked. I need the details.
I walked in to the loft, and they were there on the couch, and Dante had his shirt off, and she was in her underwear and straddling him.
Wow, there is no way Dante could talk his way out of that one.
I know, but he was stoned, so he didn't know what was going on.
Lulu, I know that you love this guy and you want to give him the benefit of the doubt, but that's like the oldest excuse in the book. A guy gets caught cheating and he's too drunk or high to remember what happened.
But I know Dante, and honestly, I've never seen him like this before. He was saying things he would never say sober.
Like what?
He didn't recognize me. He was acting like we were meeting for the first time. He had no memory of us ever being together.
I don't like the sound of this.
I don't either, but honestly, I think this is all Brooke.
Well, that part I would believe. I mean, that skank has had her eye on Dante since the day she hit this town.
I honestly was trying to write it off as, like, family and Bensonhurst crap.
Oh, please. She's been playing that one for all it's worth. And what's up with her moving across the hall from Dante? How obvious is that? She is a skank and a liar, and I'm pretty sure that I warned you about that fact.
Yes, I'm glad we're on the same page.
But if Dante really was drugged, you can be damn sure that Brooklyn is the one who drugged him.
How did Lulu seem? Was she upset? Was she crying? Was she calling me names I probably deserve?
Actually, no, she was pretty calm. She just told me to keep an eye on you, make sure you're still breathing.
I'm surprised she didn't put a pillow over my head herself.
I said I'd look after you, and she just took off.
Well, you can't blame her there.
She did say that Brooke was a total skeeve, by the way, if that counts for anything.
Did she happen to mention what Brooke and I were doing?
Yeah, you were sitting on the couch, and she was sitting in your lap in her underwear.
Oh, my God. Oh, this is so freaking bad. She's gonna think I'm a total dog. Brooke was in her underwear?
Yeah, she seemed like more than a willing participant.
Okay, this, I don't understand. Why would someone want to drug me? I gotta find a way to apologize to Lulu. That's assuming she ever talks to me ever again. So sorry.
You know, it's not something.
No, I would never do anything to hurt you, okay? And obviously I did, but I do not remember a thing. I will take a lie detector test if you want me to, anything to prove how much you mean to me.
Michael
told me that I was kissing Brooklyn, and you have to know I would never do that in my right mind. I love you. And only you. I would never cheat on you or betray you. You have to tell me what I can do to make this right.
Maxie says it's one of the oldest tricks in the book, that a guy gets caught cheating and he claims that he was stoned.
I'm not making this up. I love you. Brooke, she's like a sister to me.
Not from what I saw last night.
I was out of my mind. Okay, I don't even know what was going on. Ordinarily, sure, she's a pretty girl, but I am in no way attracted to her.
Okay, so you met her at Jake's for a drink and...
She called me up. She was upset. She wanted to talk. So I went down there. We had a few drinks. From that moment on, everything is a total blank. I know how long it took for you to trust me with your heart. I would never betray that trust.
Look, I know that you were stoned, like, the night that you found me messed up on the pier. But you didn't take advantage of me when I was throwing myself all over you, and I can't say the same for Brooke.
I know, I can't remember anything.
Well, some of it started coming back later for me, so maybe the same will happen to you.
I don't think I want to remember it.
I'm not gonna hold this against you, but I'm pissed off at Brooke for taking advantage. Yes. You can repeat it anytime.
You're amazing.
That must be a saint to overlook what you did last night.
Whatever I did. I didn't mean it.
Really? Because you hit on me at one point.
Well, then I meant that part.
There was one other thing.
What?
Well, you wouldn't tell me. It was something that you regretted, but you refused to talk about it. I don't know. I have to admit, I was intrigued.
That's a nice touch.
I agree.
You are lucky you have such a forgiving girlfriend.
Don't I know it?
So I ran into Brooklyn outside Kelly's. She's lying through her pointy little teeth about drugging Dante. That girl is guilty as sin. I think that we should work together to get that slut Brooke out of town before she can do any more damage.
Well, after what happened last night, I don't think Dante is going to touch her with a 10-foot pole.
Lulu, she lives across the hall from him. I know that Dante adores you and he's totally loyal, but do you really want her traipsing over there when you're gone, flirting with him, reminiscing about their time in Bensonhurst?
It has just been so obvious. I mean, the second she came to town, she's been hitting on him.
Well, that bimbo's days are numbered. Thanks for the cupcake.
What's your message? What's up?
I know that Brooke is a friend of the family.
Uh-huh.
But I think that she's trying to sabotage my relationship with Dante.
Well, what makes you say that?
Well, she invited Dante to Jake's last night,
uh-huh.
And I'm pretty sure she drugged him.
Hey, thanks for meeting me. Just need to get a few things sorted out.
Last night?
Yeah, Lulu says she came home and found us making out, and I don't remember any of it.
You don't? Because the only reason why I was over there is because you asked me to go.
What happened to Jake's?
We had a beer and you got nostalgic. Started saying how you could talk to me and I don't know, you needed me. I got worried about you. So that's the only reason why I was over there.
Well, it's a total blank. So I need to know. Are you the one who drugged me?